The Apostle Paul undoubtedly has one of the most transformative stories recorded in the Bible. He was a man intent on destroying the Christian faith, yet he became the greatest leader of Christianity. His efforts were crucial in spreading the gospel of Christ to nearly all regions of the known world at that time. It is no wonder that Paul is remembered in history as the apostle to the Gentiles. Paul was a Jew born in Tarsus who held Roman citizenship. He was raised as a zealous Pharisee and dedicated part of his life to persecuting followers of Christ. However, the Lord had other plans for Paul. From being a persecutor, he was transformed into one who was persecuted for the sake of Christ during his ministry as the apostle to the Gentiles. Yet few truly understand the significance of Paul's title as apostle to the Gentiles. People often overlook the importance of his divine selection to be the apostle sent to those outside of Israel. The first thing to know is that the word apostle is of Greek origin, meaning sent one or messenger, emphasizing the authority of the sender. In other words, an apostle was a messenger sent to act under the authority of the one who commissioned them. Thus, Christ's apostles did not act under their own authority, but under the authority and influence of the Lord who commissioned them. This is an interesting detail for properly understanding Paul's role as the apostle to the Gentiles. Paul was not among the 12 apostles of Jesus. He did not personally witness Jesus Christ's earthly ministry. Yet, he was called and commissioned by the resurrected Christ to be his apostle out of time. In his first letter to the Corinthians, in chapter 15, verse 8, Paul himself explained that Jesus Christ appeared to him last, after all the other apostles. He continued, "For I am the least of the apostles, and do not even deserve to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me. Whether then it is I or they, this is what we preach, and this is what you believed." Therefore, Paul's apostleship was legitimate. When we say he was the apostle to the Gentiles, it means he was the person chosen and sent by the Lord to proclaim the gospel and represent him in building the church beyond the Jewish nation. Paul is called the apostle to the Gentiles because a major portion of his apostolic ministry involved preaching the gospel to non-Jewish people as per the Lord's calling. He was the foremost missionary of the early Christian church, directly involved in spreading the gospel throughout the Greco-Roman world. Numerous biblical verses reference Paul's ministry as the apostle to the Gentiles. For example, in the book of Acts, chapter 22, verse 21, we read about Paul affirming that God had sent him to the Gentiles far away. Moreover, Paul's final declaration in the book of Acts, chapter 28, verse 28, testifies that God's salvation was sent to the Gentiles. In his letter to the Romans, chapter 11, verses 13 and 14, Paul declared, "I am talking to you, Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I take pride in my ministry in the hope that I may somehow arouse my own people to envy and save some of them." In another letter, Paul stated to the Ephesian believers that he was graced with proclaiming the unsearchable riches of Christ to the Gentiles, Ephesians 3:8. Later, writing to Timothy, Paul again affirmed, "His purpose, I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I'm telling the truth, I'm not lying, and a true and faithful teacher of the Gentiles." 1 Timothy 2:7. In Galatians chapter 1, verses 14 to 16, in one of the passages where Paul delved deeper into the origin of his ministry, he stated that although he had been an extremely capable and zealous Jew within Judaism, his ministry did not rest on these credentials. Instead, God had set him apart from his mother's womb and called him by his grace at the right time to proclaim the gospel to the Gentiles. However, it's a misconception to think that Paul preached the gospel only to Gentiles. In truth, he evangelized many Jews, One of his missionary strategies was to preach in synagogues in the cities he visited, reaching both Jews and Gentile proselytes. This aligns with the Lord's explanation to Ananias in the book of Acts, chapter 9, verse 15, when he said Paul was a chosen vessel to bear his name before the Gentiles, kings, and the children of Israel. The significance of Paul's work as the apostle to the Gentiles cannot be overstated. He founded numerous churches across the Roman Empire, including many in Asia Minor mentioned in the book of Revelation, likely established during his missionary endeavors. As the apostle to the Gentiles, Paul was undoubtedly the most important missionary in the history of the Christian church. His ministry was pivotal in growing the Christian population from a few hundred in the early church to many thousands in the following decades. It's estimated that his work directly and indirectly impacted nearly 500,000 people at that time. The book of Acts, chapter 19, verse 10, for example, states that during Paul's work in Asia, everyone in that Roman province heard the word of the Lord Jesus, both Jews and Greeks. Paul's doctrinal contribution to the church of all ages and places was also immeasurable. He did not invent his own doctrine, but taught what he received directly from the Lord, and his epistles are very clear about this. In his letter to the Galatians, he wrote, "I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that the gospel I preached is not of human origin. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it. Rather, I received it by revelation from Jesus Christ." Moreover, Paul played a key role in resolving the issue of accepting Gentiles into the Christian community. It was a transitional period when God's special revelation through the gospel of Christ began to be received by those outside the Jewish community. This generated tension within the church regarding how Gentile believers were to be received into the faith community. Some argued that Gentile believers had to embrace Judaism before being counted among God's people. Enlightened by the Holy Spirit, the apostle to the Gentiles refuted the Judaizers' idea and correctly argued that the gospel of grace needed no additions, and that faith in Jesus Christ was sufficient for salvation. Therefore, the story of the apostle to the Gentiles is a real testament to the transformative power of the gospel of Christ, which turned a fierce persecutor of Christians into one of the greatest missionaries in the history of Christianity. Paul's example of extending the reach of the gospel beyond the Jewish community, his fundamental contributions to Christian doctrine, and his unwavering commitment to spreading Christ's message, despite facing immense challenges, continue to inspire and guide Christians around the world. Now write in the comments if you already knew why Paul of Tarsus was known as the apostle to the Gentiles in the Bible.